Yes, please, everyone read by yourself. Anyone want to write it? Write down this quickly. This is basically lecture mandatory accounts. What do you mean by mandatory? Mandatory is nothing but compulsory. Mandatory is what? It's compulsory, needed. You can't able to skip it. You can't able to bypass it. So read by yourself. Okay, let's proceed. Whenever we create ledger, or whenever you want to create the ledger, for ledger creation basically you require mainly three C's. What are those? Chart of accounts, currency and calendar. Convention is optional. We'll see that, please, don't worry. Apart from these three C's, you also required following six mandatory accounts. What are those six mandatory accounts? Retained earnings, suspense account, rounding difference, translation adjustment, net income or net earnings, last one, reserve for encumbrance. So these are basically six mandatory accounts which is needed while creating the ledger. So to create ledger, what is the bare minimum requirement? Tomorrow if I am going to ask you to create the ledger, what is the bare minimum requirement or minimum requirement to create the ledger? What do you say? Three C's plus six mandatory accounts? No, don't say that. Why don't say that? Last paragraph, I'm justifying that. Last paragraph, you see, you may not able to create the ledger without first mandatory account, that is retained earnings, whereas other five are optionally mandatory. What do you mean by optionally mandatory? You want to use them, you can use them. You don't want to use them, don't use them. That's up to you, business requirement. But my company or your company or any company has to use first mandatory account, that is retained earnings. Next five, rest five are optionally mandatory. Now you people ask me, Mr. Sai, it is optional or mandatory? So I am not saying that rest of five other than retained earnings are optional, or I am also not saying that those are mandatory. Then what are those? Those are optionally mandatory. That means you want to use them, you can use them. You want to leave them also, you can leave them. System is not going to insist you. System will insist you for the first one, that is retained earnings. Retained earnings is compulsory. You are my company, any one company, any or any company across the globe has to use the retained earnings as per Oracle application. So now if I am going to ask you effectively to create the ledger, what is needed? What is the bare minimum requirement? The bare minimum requirement to create the ledger is 3 C's plus the first mandatory account, that is retained earnings. Rest of 5 accounts are optionally mandatory. It can be either optional or it can be either mandatory. So why it is optionally mandatory, we'll discuss. I'll tell you, please. I justify my wording. When I say optionally mandatory, you may get into confusion whether it is optional or mandatory. So I am saying that it is not optional, or I am also not saying that it is mandatory. I am saying smartly, smart answer, optionally mandatory. That means it can be either optional or it can be either even mandatory also. When mandatory, when optional, you leave it to me. I will be discussing in another 5 minutes. But bottom line, before I conclude this, I want to tell you that to create the ledger, you require the three C's plus the first one, retained earnings, is compulsory. First three C's plus the first one, retained earnings, is compulsory. Rest of five optionally mandatory, not mandatory, not optional, but optionally mandatory. So now next one we'll see one by one. What do you mean by retained earnings? What do you mean by suspense account? What do you mean by rounding? What do you mean by translation? What do you mean by net income? What do you mean by reserve for encumbrance? We'll have detailed discussion. So here most of the faculties across whoever teaching Oracle application, they have habit of saying what retained earnings is compulsory, mandatory, they will discuss, rectify, they go and wash their hand without discussing anything about the rest of five. But I don't want to do that job, because tomorrow I don't know what they may ask you in the interview question. So they may ask you about suspense, rounding, translation, we don't know. So that is the reason we'll focus each and every mandatory account in detail. So next 40 minutes to 1 hour we'll be focusing only on this particular retained earnings, all these mandatory accounts, please. Okay, now we'll focus one by one mandatory accounts. Each mandatory accounts will get a clarity. What is the reason, what is the purpose of retained earnings, and what is the purpose of the translation, net income, net earnings, rounding, all that we'll focus one by one. So let us start our journey with retained earnings. I will show you something on the monitor now. Please write down and we'll also discuss that one by one. Now let us see the retained earnings. First one, write down this please quickly everyone. 2012 profit and loss account, balance sheet for 2012, write down. The left side you see expenditure, the right side you see revenue, and you can also see in the balance sheet. So write down this quickly. Make it fast, please. Write down this quickly, please, everyone. Back row is visible right for you. Okay, now see this please. 2012, what is the total revenue? You can see total revenue for 2012 is sales 25, commission received 25, interest received is also 25. Total together it is 75 is the revenue for 2012. What about expenditure for 2012? The expenditure for 2012 is rent 10,000, salary 15,000, purchase 25,000. 10, 15, 25. What is total together? 50 is the expenditure. What is income? Income is 75 and expenditure is 50. Income 75, expenditure 50. So what is the profit you see? Profit for 2012 is 25. 25,000 is the profit. So what we can call this 25? Profit you call. Currently let us call it as a profit. So the same profit figure whatever we got, the same profit figure we are going to show where in the balance sheet. Where in the balance sheet?
balance sheet below capital. Below capital, what is the capital? Capital is nothing but investment. So how much you see? $475,000. $475,000. Or if you talk about Indian currency, it is 4,75,000. So there is a capital. For capital, adding to that profit, whatever you got in 2012, same profit figure, you are going to add it as a retained earnings. When you add it as a retained earnings, it's totally $500,000. So add this to capital. You are not going to actually add to the capital. In the below capital, you are going to show that. I am sorry that, you know, you are not going to actually add it. You show below capital as the retained earnings with a different heading. Where you are going to add, you are going to add somewhere else. Where you are going to add, I'll let you know. Now 2013 profit and loss account as well as 2013 balance sheet also you can see. The revenues for 2013 is 85,000. The total revenue 2030 is 85,000. The expenditure remains same expenditure, that is 50,000. The profit we could able to make is $35,000 or 35,000 INR for 2013. So here what do you do? Here you are going to add the previous year profit. Previous profit was what? 25 plus this 2013 profit is how much? 35. Earlier profit was 25. So for that you add this 35 and you are going to show retained earnings as what? 60,000. Where you show the 60,000? Below capital. Below capital, you are going to show retained earnings as 60,000. Why 60,000? 2013 profit is called as what? 2013 profit is called as 35,000. Profit is called as 25,000, but what do you call that actually? You have any unique name for that? So we don't have any unique name actually as such. This 25, you call it as a basically 2012 current year profit. And this 35, you call it as 2013 current year profit. This is called as current year profit 2012. This is called as 35,000 current year profit of 2013. So this is called as accumulated profit. So 2012 plus 2013 together, you call it as accumulated profit is called as retained earnings. So that is how you call. So this note also very clearly given. You can write down this. This is what you are supposed to tell when you go to interview also. They may ask you or they may not ask you, that I don't know. Current year profit is nothing but profit, net income, net earnings. All are more or less same. So current year profit is called as what? Profit, net income, net earnings. Whereas accumulated profit is nothing but what? Accumulated profit is nothing but retained earnings. Is this clear? Anyone, any questions, please? Yeah, what do you mean by accumulation? Accumulation is nothing but accumulating, adding. Yes, you are right. Last year was what? 25. 2012 was 25. 2013, adding to that, 25 plus 35 is called as accumulation.
adding together. Yes. So accumulated profit is nothing but retained earnings. Current year profit is nothing but, here you see, we got two current year profits. 2012 current year profit, 2013 current year profit, that is 25 and 35. So you are raising the question and you are also telling the answer by yourself. Then why you are asking a question here? Anyway, you are clear, right? That's good. Fine. So you are rechecking yourself. That's good habit, no issues. Now let us discuss about suspense account now. Let me show you something on the monitor. Write down this. Make it fast, please, everyone. Suspense account will focus now. The suspense account, generally most of the people from the accounting background, they would be knowing, because the suspense account would come in your 10 plus 2 only, that is inter, here we call first year inter, second year inter itself, you will be learning this suspense account. Plus 2, within plus 2 only you will be learning suspense. So let us understand what you mean by suspense in general. Suspense is what? Which is hidden. Generally, we used to say that the cinema is basically suspense thriller. What do you mean by suspense thriller or suspense movie? That means till end of the movie we don't know who is a killer, who is a robber, who is a murderer, we don't know. Only at the end of the movie we will be understanding the thrill. The thrill is what? Who killed the heroine, or who killed the heroine father, or heroine brother, or hero's mother? This is what the thrilling that we are going to have. So here you see, here we don't have any thrill in Oracle application suspense account, but something here also same meaning, something hidden, something unknown. What do you mean by something hidden and unknown? Let's understand what is that hidden or unknown. So whenever you pay rent, what do you write? Rent account DR, some $1,000. Cash account CR, some $1,000. So this is how you are going to write the entry. Rent, how you paid? Rent you paid by cash. So if this is the entry, then no issues, no errors, everything is perfect. There is a debit line we have, there is a credit line also we have. And there is a debit amount available, and also here you see credit amount also available. The entry is there, the amount is also there, no issues, everything is smooth, everything is perfect. But there is a scenario, there is a situation where you are not able to give the credit. Credit, wantedly you missed out, deliberately you missed out, or by mistake you missed out. If at all you mistakenly missed out this, system have ability, system got functionality, or Oracle application, they design such a way that system will come on,
command support this credit as suspense account. Here rent how you paid, rent you paid by cash, rent you paid by DD, that is demand draft, rent you paid by credit card or cash, how you paid we don't know. Rent you paid by check we don't know, credit card or that is under suspense. But rent we paid, how we paid we don't know, that is under suspense. So here you see the credit is under suspense. When credit is under suspense, system will bring this account called as suspense account CR. CR is nothing but credit. Rent paid, how you paid, that is under suspense. So system is going to temporarily allocate account called as suspense account. System will push here into credit as suspense account. Now tomorrow this is a job of auditors. Tomorrow it is a job of chartered accountants. Who is going to rectify this particular error? Their role, their job is to identify, instead of suspense account, what should come actually. Whether this rent is being paid by cash or DD or demand draft or credit card, we don't. That is under suspense. So system will take automatically suspense account. If at all you have a perfect entry here, cash account like this, such case system is not going to show you any suspense account. If the entry is perfect, amount is also perfect, no issues. No, system won't use any suspense account at all. No question of suspense account. But if in case it is missing, something is missing, that time you get suspense account. Credit as suspense. Now read this definition please, anyone? Anyone from the back row? I believe it is visible for you people also. Read this please. Okay, for you people I will read out. Whenever user is going to enter debit without credit or credit without debit, or debit balances are not matching with the credit balance, this case system will automatically populates. What do you mean by populating? Populate is nothing but displaying. System will populate suspense account the way I shown you just now. Rent is there, but rent you paid by cash or DD we don't know. System is going to show the suspense account. Here you see I also put in the first below that paragraph, you see first one I put it very clearly. This is actual entry, no errors in the entry, perfect entry. Rent paid by cash, perfect entry, actual entry, no issues. But below that you see same rent account, I put it in a different way, manner. What is that? Rent account ER, user will enter only the first line. The user will go and pause the only first line, leaving the second line. Second line is not interested to enter, or he forgot to enter deliberately or by mistake. System will give automatically the suspense account. Here you see, that's what I mentioned in the bracket. System will automatically populate the second line. Then you also see that error number 6. When that error number 6 you will get? Unbalanced general entry, suspense not allowed. When you get this unbalanced general entry? Anyone? Unbalanced general entry, when you get this? Yes, please, third row someone. Don't murmur here, don't murmur. Speak loudly. If it is wrong also, right also, I am not going to give gold medal. If it is wrong also, I am not going to take out the gold medal whichever you are already wearing. So your gold chain I don't want. Or I am not able to give you any gold chain for you. You are right also. So we are learning, let us learn, that's it. So when you get this error you get such scenario, that scenario where you are going to enter only debit when there is a credit is missing.
Credit when you get a suspense account. Okay, let me give some example so that you know more clarity you will get rather than you know I'll discuss theoretically. So let me draft something on the board. To create ledger, what is needed? To create ledger, you required ledger name. I'll give Tata Primary Ledger. This is the name of the ledger I'll give. What else I required? Chart of accounts, that is Tata structure, Tata group structure. What is this? COA, chart of accounts. Next is what currency you required. What is that? INR or USD or GBP, you can take the currency whichever you need. Next is what calendar, what is that? Tata Fiscal Cal, it's a basically calendar. So COA, currency, chart of accounts, you see, currency you taken, calendar also you taken. Apart from that, in order to create the ledger, what is needed, what is the bare minimum? The other bare minimum is you also require the retained earnings. So retained earnings also you are supposed to select. What about rest of 5? Rest of 5 is optionally mandatory. You want to use them, you can use them. You don't want to use them, don't use them. Not compulsory. That is not at all needed. Now let us assume that you also taken a suspense account. You also taken suspense account as a mandatory account, but it is not needed. So when you taken all this you taken while creating the ledger. When you taken all this you taken while creating the ledger. While creating only you will be choosing all this. So in this ledger tomorrow, if I am going to enter rent account DR2, nothing I given. If nothing I given, system will go and see that. So in this ledger, I am creating entry. In this ledger, while creating the entry, system is going to check whether suspense account is available or not. If at all suspense account is available, it is going to come out with what? It is going to come out with suspense account CR 1000. So this suspense account is coming from where? It is not coming from my pocket or your pocket. It is coming from the ledger. While creating the ledger, you will decide whether you want to go with suspense account or not. If you don't want to go for suspense account, don't give this, please. At ledger level itself is not needed. So we discussed that in order to create the ledger, you record only ledger name with the 3 C's and mandatory account called as retained earnings. Suspense account, translation, all that are optionally mandatory. But if in case you taken suspense account, what system will do? If you taken suspense account, tomorrow if you enter only debit, no credit, credit is missing, system will take automatically suspense account CR. What is that? Suspense account CR. From where it is coming up? This is not coming from anywhere else, it is coming from while creating the ledger itself, you have chosen whether you want to have suspense account or not. So here you see, if in case you are not going to give the suspense account, when you are not given any suspense account at ledger level, you should ensure that you take precautions that you should enter the entry debit as well as credit perfectly, because you should know, you should have awareness. What kind of awareness? At ledger level, suspense is not available. When ledger level suspense is not available, you need to enter, you need to take precaution
You should have clarity that there is no suspense account while creating the ledger, so you should enter debit as well as credit, both you should enter. But now this case, there is no suspense account. When there is no suspense account at all, when there is no suspense account at all, because not needed, optional, then you give only debit, rent account DR, 1000 you give, no credit you give. So when there is no credit, system will go, any time when the debit or credit is missing, system will go and check at ledger level. At ledger level, it is going to see that whether retained earnings is available. Yes, it is available. Below that, there is one more account called a suspense account. Suspense account is available or not? Suspense account is not available. So system is going to throw error message. What kind of error message? DR, unbalanced general entry, suspense not allowed. Suspense not available at ledger level. Because ledger level, user has not created any suspense account. So user would have been created suspense account and it would have been displayed. So here, we didn't create any suspense account at all. So here you see no suspense available. When no suspense available, system is going to, for this entry, system is going to get a message called as, what message? Error message you get. First thing is you get error message. And suspense account you will get when there is a suspense enabled at ledger level. No suspense is created. We created only retained earnings. So in such case you get this message. Unbalanced general entry, suspense not allowed. What do you mean by unbalanced general entry? So this is basically unbalanced general entry, suspense not allowed. Suspense not allowed in the sense what? Suspense account not available. So not availability, you get error. Available, you won't get any error, please. Is this clear? Fine gentlemen, let us proceed with next one. Next one is all about translation. We'll focus on translation now quickly. Or before I go to translation, let me discuss this reserve for encumbrance. Let me flash the document for you. Once the reserve is over, then we'll go to translation, then we'll see net income also. Net income, we already talked about net income, there is nothing that I need to discuss. Net income is nothing but what? Current year profit. Current year profit is nothing but net income or net earnings. This I already discussed while discussing the reserve for encumbrance. While discussing the retained earnings. Retained earnings, I told you, current year profit. Retained earnings is what? Accumulated profit is called as retained earnings. Whereas current year profit is nothing but net income or net earnings. So this we already discussed about net income, net earnings. We also discuss about retained earnings. Suspense account also we discuss. Now let us discuss about reserve for encumbrance. Let me show you document. Yes, please, everyone read by yourself. Anyone want to write down, you can also write down this.